There isn't really any doubt that climate change has significant financial impacts. If you look at the increasing number of the weather-related catastrophes, you can see that the insurance are paying a lot more money to people who have lost their houses or assets as a result of climate change. There are studies that show that almost $43 trillion of assets and investment could be basically wiped off as a result of climate change-related risks. It's very important that businesses start planning for climate change. Unlike what people assume most of the times, climate change isn't something far off in the future. It's a real threat that can affect businesses and investments in the long run.
Climate change and the process of global warming could become one of the biggest risks to economic stability around the world, according to the Governor of the Bank of England. Mark Carney, speaking in London tonight, warned that the time to act was finite and shrinking.
The combination of the weight of scientific evidence and the dynamics of the financial system suggest that in the fullness of time, climate change will threaten financial resilience and longer-term prosperity.
And the basic problem is that businesses and corporations in particular are not taking into account the risk of climate change seriously. If you look at the mainstream financial reportings of Canadian banks, for example, you could see that annual information firms or management discussions and analyses, they do not provide any meaningful analysis, in most cases, of the impacts of climate change on the businesses of these institutions.
On climate-related financial risk, we'd like to thank Michael Bloomberg and the members of the Industry Task Force on Climate-Related Financial Disclosures. Last week, they published an excellent set of recommendations that can help transform market understanding of climate-related risks and opportunities that companies face. Although this was catalyzed by the FSB in response to a direct request by the G20, this is a private sector, industry-led effort. These are recommendations for the market, by the market.
The task force recommendations call on companies to disclose how climate change is affecting their businesses and financial operations, and what kind of strategy they're adopting in response to climate change. The task force recommendations are really important because they can ensure that disclosure on climate change-related financial information are consistent and of higher quality, so that they allow investors to make informed decisions over the long run. In terms of the best way to implement the TCFD recommendations, I think a voluntary approach would be desirable. So it's really important for the leaders of the business community and institutional investors such as pension funds to encourage their investee companies to adopt the TCFD recommendations in a timely way. But if that voluntary adoption doesn't work and markets do not embrace the TCFD recommendations in a timely way, regulators should then take action. And as I mentioned before, the adoption of the TCFD recommendations would be a win-win situation for everyone. It would be good for the investors because they can make informed decisions, and would be good for corporations because it would allow them to prepare for climate change and have a strategy to deal with it. It would be also good for the Canadian economy because it would allow it to operate on a transparent basis and also transition into a lower carbon economy.